Breaking news on a fight over faith tonight. After weeks of complaints, the organizers of a satanic black mass that was going to be held at the prestigious Harvard University tonight, announcing that they are moving their event off campus. Then they said they were no longer holding it at all. And now we're hearing another group may hold it instead. Tony Perkins is the president of the Family Research Council, and Bernard Whitman is a Democratic pollster and president and CEO of Whitman Insight Strategies. We want to talk about this, as well as this football player incident that's getting all this attention tonight. Let me start with the satanic mass, Bernard, that's now apparently been canceled because there has been so much pressure on this group that wanted to mock Christianity, mock the Eucharist, and thought it would be really fun to have some sort of devil-worshipping event on campus.
You know, this is the right outcome. I'm glad that they decided not to have it. But I have to say, I agree with both Drew Faust, who's the president of Harvard, and Luther Ziegler, who's the president of Harvard's chaplains. I mean, Drew Faust said, you know what, this is abhorrent, it shouldn't be held, but the principle of free expression is absolutely sacrosanct. It underpins not only Harvard, but our entire democracy, freedom of expression. Mm-hmm. But Ziegler, the president of the Harvard chaplain, said something, I think, even more powerful. He said, the best way to overcome hatred is to overwhelm it. And I think rather than be overly concerned about a very small minority who have abhorrent views, rather he's doing what we all should do when faced with these situations and showing how love and acceptance can trump that. And as I understand it, the Catholic Church is holding two separate events to demonstrate the belief the Catholics have in Christ.
I get it. But love and acceptance of all people is good, Tony. But the problem is, is there a double standard? Because if some group wants to hold an event on Harvard's campus denigrating the prophet Muhammad, what do you think is likely to happen there?
Well, 3/4 of Americans self-identify as Christian, and the communion, the Eucharist, is important to both Catholic and Protestants. I agree with that with Bernard. I'm glad this came out the way it did, but I do think there is a double standard in that it's okay to mock Christianity. We're demanding more and more from society. Society is demanding that Christians be tolerant of those who express views that are contrary to Christianity and outright hostile towards Christianity. But increasingly, there's little sensitivity given to those things that are held dear to Christians.
And speaking of which, so there's been this controversy today over this football player, Michael Sam, who's been drafted to go into the NFL, to the St. Louis Rams. He was almost the last draft pick. And at the cameras are always there at these NFL draft picks, I guess. I don't know. I don't follow it. That's what they tell me. And he was like 7th from last. And when he gets the news, you can see he's very happy. And he and his boyfriend, he's the first openly gay NFL player. He and his boyfriend share a kiss. Well, this has caused all sorts of controversy by some, and now there's been a backlash against them. Bernard, I want to start with this. Do you see a difference in the way Michael Sam has been treated and the attention given to him and what we saw with Tim Tebow and the expressions of his faith that were actually condemned in a lot of circles?
Well, I think that situations actually are different. I think Michael Sam is deserving of huge praise. Why? Because he is the first openly gay player in the most popular sport in America, which has traditionally been a bastion of hypermasculinity and a bastion of homophobia. And in fact, I think what Michael Sam did was extraordinarily courageous, because Christianity is pervasive in the NFL. They pray in the locker room, they pray in the huddle, and I think that's great. But there's never been before an openly gay player. And as ubiquitous as Christianity is on the playing field and in the locker rooms, homophobia is also pervasive. And I think that now that we have a gay player, I'm hopeful that will decrease. And in fact, a recent poll of NFL athletes by ESPN shows that 2/3 of athletes have heard coaches or teammates use homophobic slurs, mm-hmm. but 86% would support a gay teammate. So I'm very hopeful. And I think that Sam actually could be the Jackie Robinson of the gay community.
What do you make of it, Tony? Because Tim Tebow, even though faith is pervasive throughout the NFL, boy, oh boy, did he take a lot of mocking.
Well, what happened?
Scorned.
I don't think it was so pervasive that John 3:16 was no longer able to put on under his eyes. Look, I think the NFL sent a very clear message. That message was, it's okay for, if you're an NFL player, for you to embrace your boyfriend on national television, but it's not okay for you as an NFL player to embrace your faith. I mean, we saw last year where there were those involved in the draft and were speculating on where Tebow might go, saying that no team will pick him up because of the media circus that will follow him. when in fact there was a bias against his faith. But here, I mean, and he was a Heisman Trophy winner. So when you compare their talents and their skills, really no comparison. But the media circus, look, it's going to be following. It's going to be following very closely behind Sam's. But what's really disturbing here, and I'm a free market person. I think the team has the right to pick him up. He has the right to play. No problem there whatsoever. But here you have a player in Miami, Don Jones, who tweets out, "Oh man, after this kiss, you know, he doesn't like it." What happens to him? He's sent to re-education camp. Come on.
Wait, I mean, he tweeted out, "OMG," and quote, "horrible." That he called it horrible. The kissing
that was
moment.
His expression.
Horrible. But, go ahead, Bernard. What of that? Should he have been punished for tweeting out OMG
well,
horrible?
Well, let's look to the free market. Michael Sam's jersey, which I bought on Saturday night, is the number two selling jersey right behind Jerry Manziel's, ahead of the number one draft pick. There is tremendous change in American society, increasing embrace of homosexuality in daily life, and I think this is just a basic expression of that. And the fact is that a lot of gay guys happen to like football. I like football. I want to see Michael Sam succeed. I hope I can see him wear his jersey on the field.
What do you make of Tony's point about how the Miami Dolphins guy, Don Jones, should not have been punished for tweeting out his view?
I believe there's a morals clause in the NFL. They have to not bring disgrace upon the team. And the fact is that was an inappropriate expression. They work for the NFL. And to Tony's point, my good friend Tony, Christianity is absolutely embraced in the NFL. If you watch football, and I'm sure you do, anytime they have a microphone in the huddle, you hear them praying. Anytime there's a microphone in the locker room, you hear them praying.
Word.
I think that's fine.
Go ahead, Tony.
Look, fairness, a fair playing field where people are able to express themselves. If Sam's can express himself, Jones and everybody else ought to be able to express themselves as well.
Good debate, you guys. Thanks for being here.
Thank you, Megan.